Nothing on that beat.
Addicted to balling, I have to get my cash. The money is calling, got bands, got bands, got bands. I'm addicted to balling. I'm addicted to balling. I have to get my ends. I pull up in my Benz, flexing, counting my bands. Started getting money, I see how it feels to be rich. I live by the beach now, that's how I should live. Since I was a toddler, I knew that I would become this. I cannot move slow, that's a big, big no. Gotta chase this money, bankroll after big bankroll. I must get this money, I must get this money. I must get this money, get this money, get this money. I'm addicted to balling, I have to get my cash. The money is calling, got bands, got bands, got bands. I'm addicted to balling. I'm addicted to balling. I have to get my ends.
Got 100 on these bands. Now look at my dance. What? That's my jam. Run and get you that Benz. Turning that party up. Used to have a my Nautica. Know the money be calling up. Friend, I'm tryna all of ya. Talking body ballin', watch this. Started let me too quick. Went to Oakland with a few. Took them all your break. Dip. Yeah. Imagine what I paid for the Rollie. Still from the police. 24 carats on my Kobe. Yeah. For the homies.
I'm addicted to balling. The money is calling. I'm addicted to balling. I'm addicted to balling. I have to get my ends.
Seen the best of them, Jando. 25 to life in the canto. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phones, they can hear us.
When you got dumb cake up in the say that they be waiting for you in the bushes with the duct tape. Up and down the interstate. Yeah, we really touch.
We touch
October. I'm about to another state. He went down in Arizona. Don't get me involved. Come an on. Empty box in the car means they coming for all.
I mean, it's
I had six phones. I got rid of them all. We get hit and sit down. We don't talk to the law. Yeah, they think I'm tripping. They listen. They know our every move. Yeah, they want us all in prison. That's why I can't sleep at night until they get in. I'm on another mission. I'm just young and I'm living.
Yeah. I done seen the best of them, Jando. 25 to life in the canto. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phones, they can hear us.
7 in the morning and they in my home. My bank account's froze. What is going on? Why it all start going wrong? From talking
My phone still echo. The feds won't let go. Money never sleeps when you're the Black Gordon Gecko. Line looking like they waiting on the retro. Sixes, I feel special. Resale and I never pay retail. My shoebox money afforded me the spree wells. And that then courted me a V12. Avoid the phones if it's sounding like a seashell. Too much clicking in the connection. Connect the dots with my connect for my protection. Face to face, I place my like a drive-thru. You know how I do, push.
I done seen the best of them, Jando. 25 to life in the canto. Never met a man that they can't talk. We're talking on the phones, they can hear us.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL takes us to the architectural wonder that is the Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta. A moment ago, here was the scene. The Falcons coming out from their tunnel to the roar of all the folks here in Atlanta. We're ready for football as these Falcons get set to match up with the Los Angeles Rams. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back.
Back here, this will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. First carry for the tailback, Devontae Freeman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll make it a second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down. Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. And before this 4th-and-3 play, we're going to get whistles and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And it appears they'll go for it here on fourth down. A big call on the game's opening drive. They'll run for it. It's Freeman. And he is not going anywhere. They stop him for no gain. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Rams get the football in outstanding field position. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Here's the first carry now for Todd Gurley. And he's taken down inside the 30. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
And he's got the hook up here. It's Woods. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Now on second down, this is Gurley. And not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. First down, L.A., Goff finding Higbee. On first down, Goff. That is incomplete. Robert Alford that time on the great coverage.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
Second and 10, Goff again. Looking left sideline, incomplete. That time trying to find Gerald Everett, and it's third down.
I think he's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Again, Goff. And that will be incomplete as well.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. And Zuerlein's kick is good. And the Rams have the first points here. It's 3-0. So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get three.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. This is brought in by Hardy. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A good pickup there, a 22. They'll run it now out of the gun. They'll get only a couple down to the 44.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it, because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two. They've got a second down and eight to start things out. Sanu, good for an Atlanta first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. First and 10, it's Ryan. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. So he can't hang on, and as I watch that unfold, I remembered an expression that I've heard, maybe from you, I don't know, but you're going to get hit anyways, might as well hold on to the ball.
Right, you know a coach said that, right? Yeah. Not an actual player? Not a chance at all. Way easier said than done.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. Second and 10, it's Ryan again. And he's caught right at the 10-yard line. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Keeps it on the sneak. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. On the keeper, here's Ryan. And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Taking it in, and the Falcons are in for 6.
And the sneak works on second and goal. They didn't wait until it was fourth down to try and get him across.
No, and I think if you're the QB, you like these plays. Don't you? I mean, you want to hand it off sometimes, but also prove that you can get it in there as well.
Yeah, it makes you really part of the gang, doesn't it? It makes you part of the crew, and it really bonds you with those big offensive linemen because then you get to celebrate with the big fellas.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And last time, able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. Across the 30 to the 31-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting 3rd and about 4 to go.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
After the run, Goff gonna throw. He's letting it fly for Cooks. It's caught inside the 25. Goff finding Cooks on a big play, 47 yards.
We just saw him hit a big play there on a deep post. And most of the time, the post isn't available because you usually have defenders in the middle of the field. But if you throw enough curls and crossing routes and underneath routes, I know from experience, they get tired of watching those balls get caught. They start to creep up a little bit, and that's when you can hit them big over the top.
Goff now looking to throw. Throw left side, complete to Kupp. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. They'll run it now out of the gun. He takes this down to about the 12 for a gain of 3. The offense on third down tonight, they've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third and a few inches. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. The Rams on third down, they've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. He may try and run for this. Only a yard there on the keeper, but that's all he needed. First down. First down now, but that clock rolling.
And what a weapon to have when you can use your quarterback as a short yardage runner and pick up first downs.
Now they'll pitch it back to Gurley. And he'll take this one inside the 10, down to the 8. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Clock continuing to roll as the Rams try to get going again. One to Gurley, and they'll get him down here at about the 5 yard line. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively though to hold it to a short game.
On third down, they'll run it with Gurley. And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown. Todd Gurley, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Rams are in for 6. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. Zuerlein connects on the extra point. And the lead is now 10-7. Zuerlein out now to kick this one away. This will be taken short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Seconds, all that remains in the first half as they come up on first down. And the play clock running very low, so Dan Quinn decides to call for a timeout. As the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. First down. Looking deep for Julio. Looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Nickell Roby Coleman. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
That late in the clock, second quarter, why not just run it a time or two and get it into the locker room?
What you're saying makes absolutely perfect sense. Run it and get out of there. But I'm just wondering if the pressure of today's NFL and the high-powered offenses that you're facing may have forced them into saying, let's try and get some more points.
And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. And an out, and a loose football, and the Falcons grab it, and they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. Now the pitch to Freeman. Flashed the stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Second down. Got a man that's caught at the 6-yard line. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones in the final seconds of the first half. And the Falcons are in for six. Bryant's extra point up and good. And the lead is now 14-10. Here's Bosher to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. And the Rams getting set to go now. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10. And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home and they'll stop him behind the line. All right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime. So we are at halftime here in Atlanta with the Falcons out in front. The Falcons back to receive. They've got the lead, and they'll get this football as the second half gets underway. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Forced out to his left. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Well, you know, thinking back to last week around the league, it was one, we've had some crazy weeks this year, Charles, but this was one of the crazier, maybe the craziest week that we've had. You think about the 99-yard run that sort of kicked it all off. Of course, that wild finish in Miami. I mean, we saw a bunch of interesting things.
We certainly did. How about the three worst teams by record in the NFL? The Jets, the Raiders, the 49ers all won on the same weekend. We had overtime in Kansas City and in Dallas. And the two frontrunners in the NFC, New Orleans got a scare in Tampa Bay. and the Rams lost in Chicago.
Yeah, crazy, crazy weekend. It figures to be a crazy finish the rest of the way in this NFL season. And he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's 3rd and 2 now.
Well, there's an example of patience being rewarded. Ran the ball on first down and got stuffed. Most people would scream, throw the ball here in this situation. They stayed with their roots, stayed with running the football, and they got rewarded.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Now Goff on first down. And that's caught left side. It's Woods. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. Back to the ground game here, Gurley. And he's going to bring this one down to right about the 20-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
They got 2 of the 3 they needed there. Leaves him with 3rd and just 1 yard. Now Gurley. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play. And that's going to lead them to 4th down.
They tried their best to pick up that 3rd and 1, but their surge wasn't enough to counteract what came back at them from the defensive side, was it?
Offensive line, especially in the middle, looked like they were on skates a little bit when that one started.
So now we bring up 4th and inches. This would be a critical call.
Dancing to his left. And it's complete. He's got it in the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. Brandon Cooks, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Rams are in for 6. And this is no good. It's a missed extra point. Boy, in a tight game, how important might that turn out to be here as the second half rolls along? Zerline out now to kick this one away. Here comes the Falcons offense. It's their first possession of the second half now. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up there. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Aaron Donald in there to get him for what will be a loss of 13 yards.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Ryan. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. The pressure really ratcheting up. They get the sack on first down, then a near sack. They got to him there just as it was leaving his hand.
Yeah, they might need to change their pass protection scheme a little bit. Maybe bring another guy into the backfield to help protect the quarterback, because that was awfully close.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. From the gun, it's Ryan. And he comes back with 1 complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. Now they'll get 15, but that won't be nearly enough. It's 4th down.
I don't know how many times, not just in my playing career, but you and I working together, have we ever heard a coach say, you know, I just don't have that play on my call sheet. And that's really what we had here. That was a big hole they were trying to get out of.
Yeah, big gain, still a ways to go, though. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles.
Goff will lead the Rams up here, first and 10 at the 20.
Six. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack.
This well upfield across the 45. A gain of 32 that time.
Usually hitting a deep post pattern, as we just saw there, for a big gainer. That's tough to do because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. But if you hit enough crossers and underneath routes and curls, you start to get those guys creeping up, wanting to make plays on the football. It's the equivalent of a changeup in baseball. You show your other stuff, throw the changeup. And on that play, it worked for big yardage.
Back to the workhorse today. It's Gurley. And he'll get it down here to the 43. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's been a good one so far, just a 2-point game here as we get set for quarter number 4. A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. Play action here on first down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Bruce Irvin in there to sack him for a loss of 6. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
Here's gone. And he's going to go down again. Bruce Irvin in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. A play fake to Gurley. Now gone. And this is going to be incomplete.
Okay, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. And yeah, that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and 4 and second and 8 and 9.
From the 26, they'll line up on second and 4. Second down, here's Ryan. And down he goes on the pressure from the Rams defense. Aaron Donald in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
So the sack pushes him back, and now third and long for Ryan and the Falcons. From the shotgun, Ryan. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line, Aaron Donald. Able to disrupt yet another pass play, his third sack of the afternoon. One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it.
Ready! Play 25! Check 26, check 26. Ready to go!
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Ndamukong Suh. Able to swap him from that defensive tackle spot for a loss of five. It's first and goal, and a late touchdown at this stage could officially salt this one away. They'll come out in the pistol. On first and goal, Gurley. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Todd Gurley, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams add on to their lead. Zerline out now to kick this one away. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense. Defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they... Under pressure, and they got to him again. Aaron Donald in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
Now it's Ryan. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Ethan Westbrooks in there to get him, and this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays. Here's Ryan. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. John Johnson with the INT, and they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. Out incomplete.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Let's go. Here we go, fellas. Here we go.
Now gone. Steps away to his left. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
DC.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Grady Jarrett. The Falcons going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. Goff and his guys not coming off the field. They're going for this.
11. Shell.
They go ahead and snap it. Gone. Going up top for Cup. That's caught inside the 20. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Throwing now. Goff. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Woods. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. So now with 6 seconds remaining, we get a timeout on the field. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. Goff now to throw. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. And now we'll get a timeout here. They're able to stop it with 1 second to go in this game. Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. Now it's gone. Being chased out left. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at EASports.com. With that, we say so long, everybody.